You ever thought about the day after Christmas? Some of you are like, Pastor Jeff, it is the day after Christmas. What are you talking about? And yes, if you're watching this on December 26, when it releases, it is the day after Christmas, but I'm not talking about our day after Christmas. I'm talking about the day after the very first Christmas, the one when Christ was born. Ever thought about that? Well, on this Sabbath Sunday, when we stop our normal work and activity to give our staff, volunteers, even our facility a rest, I want us to think about the day after Christmas. If you don't know, my name is Jeff Manis, and I'm the lead pastor here at Element. And the day after Christmas in most of our lives is probably pretty similar. Perhaps there are family and friends nearby playing games. Maybe there are remnants of gift wrapping, and if there are kids involved, they are absolutely playing with their new toys or trying on their clothes like a fashion show. Most definitely, there's some good food, and most likely, there's a lot of relaxing by the fire or on the couch with a good book or a classic movie. I mean, change out a few of the details, and for most of us, the day after Christmas looks about the same. But what about the day after the very first Christmas? Have you ever thought about that? We never really talk about this, and for good reason, right? Christmas Day, that moment when Christ entered the world in human form, God in the flesh, the Savior with skin on, Emmanuel, God with us, Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, the angels announcing to the shepherds, there is good news for all people. I mean, this is the crowning moment in human history. Yes, the death and resurrection of Jesus was the culmination of God's plan of salvation. But without Christmas, there's no Easter, no God to die in our place, no empty tomb. So of course we make much of Christmas. But have you thought about the day after Christmas? Only Luke records details about the birth of Christ on Christmas Day, and none of the four Gospels mention anything about the following day, so we're left with our imaginations only. Matthew picks up the story with the Magi, the wise men, coming to worship Jesus, which most scholars believe was months, if not years, after the birth of Christ. Luke picks up the story 8 days after the birth of Jesus. Mark just bypasses the birth story altogether, starting his letter with the baptism of Jesus. And John, as only John can do, starts his letter with a beautiful poetic description of Jesus as the eternal Word who came in the flesh. So again, we have no historical record of what happened the day after. No letter from Mary written to her mom, no records from the inn or oral tradition passed down from Joseph to his children, nothing. So have you ever thought about the day after Christmas? Mary had just given birth, and now day one for Jesus, and they are still in a barn, a stable of some kind, with who knows what kind of animals in their midst, cows, goats, chickens, maybe a stray cat or two. We know they were strays because a good follower of Yahweh would never own a cat, right? But I digress. Even if there were no animals, it was still a barn, a holding pen of some kind for animals. We can't imagine birthing any child in a barn today, let alone the Lord, God in the flesh. No medical professionals to care for Mary or Jesus, no cleanup crews to take care of all the mess, no hospital kitchen or loved ones to provide meals, no preheated blankets to wrap Jesus in, no comfortable bed for Mary, no cable TV, Wi-Fi, social media updates with the perfect lighting and matching color scheme, like none of that. Have you ever thought about the day after Christmas? Just comparing it to the modern day model of our day after Christmas, there were no other family or friends we're aware of. Some believe the reason there was no room for Mary and Joseph had as much to do with their status as unwed and pregnant as it did being busy from a census. Bethlehem was Joseph's family town. There had to be cousins, aunts, uncles, maybe even immediate family of his in Bethlehem, but they were all alone in a stable, with a donkey, some chickens, goats, and that stray cat to keep them company. The Magi hadn't come yet, so there was no remnants of gifts to celebrate or use. I'm not being crude, but there would have been remnants of something, right? It just wasn't gifts. I mean, you don't give birth in a pile of hay in first century Israel and not have some remnants that remain. That's just real talk right there. No fire to warm yourself, or if there was, definitely no couch with a book or a movie to enjoy. None of that. I mean, have you ever thought about the day after Christmas? Have I painted the picture well enough? Have I successfully brought down all the joys of Christmas for you? Some of you are like, wow, Pastor Jeff, I'm starting to think I shouldn't have watched this on the day after my Christmas, but don't give up yet. Just like the angels declared good news, there is some good news in this story as well. You see, most likely, Mary and Joseph had nothing the day after Christmas, at least nothing our world would desire. No gifts or meals, no house with a fire, no friends or family to speak of. On their day after Christmas, most people would look at Mary and Joseph and say they had nothing. But in reality, they had everything. In fact, they had the only thing that mattered. Only it wasn't a thing, it was a person. Isn't it interesting that when we talk about the day after Christmas, we automatically go to the stuff, the things, the experiences, the circumstances? We think, poor Mary and Joseph had nothing. And maybe you're better than me and that's not where your mind goes, but for me, that's where my mind goes. At least that's where it did. Yet in the midst of all their nothingness, Mary and Joseph had it all because Mary and Joseph had Jesus. Jesus was there. The day after Christmas, Christ had been born. At our Christmas Eve services a few days ago, I preached from Psalm 23, and verse 1 of that famous passage says it all. The Lord is my shepherd. I have all that I need. I don't know what your day after Christmas looks like. It might be filled with everything this world desires, or maybe it's more like Mary and Joseph than you'd like to admit. Not a lot to show for it. But whether you have a Christmas with everything or a Christmas with nothing, the question is, do you have the only thing that matters? Do you have Jesus on this day after Christmas? Have you ever thought about the day after Christmas? I hope you'll never stop thinking about it now, because the truth about the day after Christmas is the truth we need today. Whether I have everything or nothing, Jesus is all I need. I pray we'd live out that truth in our lives, not just today or next year's day after Christmas, but every day of our lives. If you've never put your faith in Jesus, he's just a prayer away. In fact, you can pray right now, Father in heaven, I believe Jesus is God who came in the flesh. Jesus, you died in my place. You rose from the dead, so I put my faith in you. Please forgive me of my sins. Wash me clean and make me new. I repent of the way I've lived my life and I turn to follow you in a new way, in a new life. I receive from you salvation. Please live in my heart and empower me to live my life for you with the help of your Holy Spirit. Thank you for loving me, Jesus. You are all I need. You pray that prayer and Jesus will live in your heart. Your sins will be forgiven. One day you'll live forever with Jesus, and he'll change your life every single day, not just the day after Christmas. I love you guys so much, Element. I hope you had an amazing Christmas day. But more than that, I hope today, the day after Christmas, you will have what really matters, that you will have Jesus Christ himself.